Some years ago, did good Queen Bess a trade monopoly decree for Brits to trade from east to west. From 1600, there was just the East India Company. We were the agents of imperialist expansion and ran much of India in true business fashion. For here were the goodies we could sell back in Blighty. And here was a market that was really quite mighty. We bought up the cotton, the spices and silk, sold watches and trinkets and things of that ilk. But India is only a small part of our tale. Our interests required us to maximise sales. China, which had an immense population, was an obvious target for benign exploitation. The problem was this. The wily Chinese wanted to sell us nothing but tea. They wouldn't accept any quid pro quo. When we offered them baubles, they just said no. So the East India Company hit on a scheme. It was a wee bit cunning, a wee bit mean. After market research, we worked out a plan. Sell opium in Canton and run the main man. The rich kids had become serious dopers. But it wasn't a habit of the mass of no-hopers. The company changed that in a matter of years, creating millions of addicts by supplying cheap gear. We all had to be a little tiny bit careful. The deals that we did were the grey side of legal, but the problem was simply the rules of the game. Deregulation would make it all plain. Now the monopoly's a thing of the past. It's a free-for-all, and we can't be the last to get stuck in and create more jobs to stave off uncouth Chartist mobs. I've never had qualms in this line of business. If the punters want it, the market suffices to satisfy demand, and meanwhile, let them get high while I make my pie.
Thank you so much for the assistance and information so handsomely afforded us, Sir Jardine Matheson, leading to so satisfactory...